It officially happened. Nvidia finally revealed the 30 series for their graphics cards. Let's talk about it. Welcome back, folks, to another Tech Control video. In this video, we are going to cover the graphics cards. Man, those things are powerful. So let's talk about them. If you've seen a video or two on this channel and you like what we are producing, make sure to show us by hitting that big red subscribe button below, share with a buddy or two, like, even comment, and that lets us know that you want us to keep at it. So during the Nvidia event, they talked about a lot of things, mostly about the graphics card, and let's be honest, that's all we really care about. So they mentioned DLSS 2.0, and that's a great feature or technology that these Nvidia cards have. Not only that, but the next gen consoles have their own version, more or less, of what that is. But again, we're here for the video cards, so let's talk about them. So we're coming off the 20 series cards, the 2070 and the 2080 Ti. Now they unveiled the 30 series, specifically the 3070, 3080, and surprise, 3090, even though it was leaked. And I covered it on this channel during our news roundup. But regardless, let's get into a little bit of the details about each of these cards. These are based off of the new Ampere architecture. I'm gonna put up a graphic here. I'll leave a link in the description from where I stole this from. But this is pretty much the best graphic that I could find that kind of puts it all together. Did I say steal? I meant borrowed. It doesn't matter, I'm giving them full credit. I stole it, whatever. So they're sticking with the RTX naming for these new cards. We're coming off of the higher end, which was the RTX 2080 Ti. And now the 3070, or I should say the RTX 3070. This is now the lower end of the three new ones that they announced. And it can already outperform the RTX 2080 Ti. And it does it at a cheaper price too, nearly half, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not sure what the 2080s go for nowadays, but we'll talk about the pricing in a sec for each of these. So sticking with the 2080 Ti, let's talk a little bit about it so that you can understand and compare where we're coming from and what we're going to. The 2080 Ti was sporting 11 gigs of RAM, of VRAM I should say. The 3070 is now coming in at 8 gigabytes of VRAM. So even though it has less memory than the 2080 Ti, it's actually still more efficient, clocking in at a 13.4 teraflop. The 3080 Ti is actually coming in at 10 gigabytes of VRAM. And this one is the one that uses the new advanced GDDR6X RAM. 2080 also consumed 250 watts of power. Speaking of power, now they're more efficient than they were before. They're able to produce 55% more airflow. They're 3 times quieter. They're 30% more efficient. They have new air that flows directly through them. So what does it really mean when you talk about efficiency? Not only power efficiency, but also heat. They generate less heat. Moving on to the 3070, it's almost a direct comparison with the high-end 2080 that we had previously. These cards are so powerful that you can already see it's 20.4 teraflops compared to the 13.4 that the 2080 Ti had before. Another thing to note, coming from the previous generation, those sported a 12 nanometer processor. Now these new Ampere graphics cards, they sport a Samsung 8 nanometer processor. And now the one that everyone is most interested in, at least from what I can tell, is definitely gonna be the one to fly off the shelves, not only for the price, but also for what it does, it's a great value, is the 3080, the RTX 3080. And it's coming in at a huge 29.8 teraflops. Obviously, this is gonna consume a little bit more power, 320 watts, with 28 billion transistors, sporting the same Samsung 8 nanometer processor that I mentioned before. And the best part is the price. It's coming in at $699. Again, especially when you compare it directly with what we had out on the market with the 2080 Ti, this was, if I'm not mistaken, $1,000. You can probably find sales and things like that, but I mean, man, I feel bad for anybody who bought a 2080 Ti for $1,000 in the last 6 months, and now you're seeing this 3080 for $700 that is basically double the performance, more than double actually. And finally, they also unveiled the RTX 3090. Now this one is a big boy. I mean, it's almost meme like big. I'm sure there'll be memes about it. So he actually whipped this one out of his oven, and this isn't the first time we've seen the CEO of Nvidia do this. He also did this before, back when they were talking about the new servers and AI. Let's get into the details really quickly. The 3090 is also using the GDDR6X RAM. This one has 24 gigabytes of VRAM. That's a crazy amount. It's coming in at 35.7 teraflops. 35.7. But we still don't know if it's able to run Flight Sim 2020. This one will be consuming 350 watts of power, and it's going to come in at the low price of $1,500. So who is this 3090 for? Well, they're claiming that it's supposed to be able to handle 8K60. And now that's a tall order. And honestly, I have no doubts that it can do it. But my thing is, who's gaming in 8K right now? I don't even know any games that are, I mean, maybe one or two that can even go up to 8K. I mean, even right now, the adoption rate for 4K is about 50%. It's still not, you know, as high as it is for 1080 or anything like that. People are still gaming on 1080, let alone 4K. And now here comes this card at 8K, $1,500. This is why I don't think this one will fly off the shelves, but the previous model, the 3080, will. Another thing to note is that there's a big price gap between the 3080 and the 3090. So I'm guessing that this is where the 3080 Ti will come into play and will be priced roughly right around in between both of those. Looking at the stock market, Nvidia's stock rose since last Friday nearly 50 points. During the announcement, while they were having their press conference, it actually rose up to 25 points. It did eventually go a little bit back down, but still it finished very positive by the end of the day. Looking at its competition, AMD, they actually did finish positively, but only raising by 1 point. I'm sure AMD is happy that they didn't lose any points in the stock market, so that's still a win. Now, AMD, we still don't know what their next line of graphics cards are going to be. We know that they've been working with Navi architecture and RDNA 2.0, obviously because of the next-gen consoles and things like that. But they've yet to make an announcement of what their next graphics cards or their line of cards are going to be. I don't know if they're able to compete with Nvidia at this high level that Nvidia is. There is a market for them, maybe in the lower end, or maybe even something up to the 3070 Ti. Maybe that might be their higher end, but it's obviously going to have to be at a cheaper price. So when can you pick these up? Well, later at the end of this month, towards the second half of this month, I should say. I'll leave the dates below. Actually, it's in the chart, so I'll just bring up that chart one more time. But before that, you need to go to Nvidia's website and sign up for the pre-orders. Some of the other Tech Control members are debating whether they're going to rebuild a new computer or not. We're still talking about that, but if we do, we most likely will. We'll probably do it here for you guys. So make sure that you are subscribed to the channel so you can see that build with these new, I don't know, 3070 or 3080, whichever one we decide to go with, but it most likely probably will not be that 3090. Anyway, stay tuned for more. We'll keep the news and the updates and all this other stuff coming. So make sure to follow us on Twitter, Instagram. You can hit us up on both of those. We're pretty active. And let's talk games. Let's talk tech. Take care.